Funny enough, Carl Reiner didn't always have his sights set on comedy. However, there was a small problem.
I was missing two things to be an opera singer: pitch and timing.
Reiner was born in 1922 to Jewish immigrants, a watchmaker and homemaker in New York.
I went to the movies in the Bronx when I was a kid. I saw Ronald Coleman. I said, oh, it's so good. I'll never be there, but I want to be an actor. I could talk like him.
Growing up in the Great Depression, Reiner sought free acting classes offered by FDR's Works Progress Administration. After serving in World War II, he headed to Broadway, where he caught the attention of someone working in a new medium, television.
Stop forgetting one very important thing. Lunch.
Show of Shows was my college with Sid Caesar and Imogene Coker, best writers in the history of this business. I really learned to write and learned about what constitutes good comedy.
After a decade of working with Sid Caesar, Reiner needed a new creative outlet. As he told Conan O'Brien, he didn't have to go far.
I was being offered situation comedies. I read a few of these and they weren't very good. My wife, in her infinite wisdom, said, why don't you write one?
Reiner created and starred in Head of the Family. It flopped at CBS, but Reiner's agent had an idea.
We'll get a better actor to play you.
Although the show got a new cast and a new title,
The Dick Van Dyke Show,
Reiner stayed to run the series, regularly appearing on it as well.
Whatever you were going to say to Laura, I would rather you said to me.
Okay, Rob, if that's the way you want it. Rob, you're a beautiful girl.
The 5 years I spent with Carl Reiner and Mary Tyler Moore on The Van Dyke Show were the five best years of my life. The most fun I ever had, the most creative, and I think I learned the most working with Carl Reiner that I ever
learned
did.
Learned what? Timing?
About comedy, about human behavior, about everything. Carl could have been a psychiatrist. He understands people so well.
The world is full of normal neurotics, and we like to see ourselves, and I think we saw ourselves in Dick.
While on set, Reiner developed a passion for directing. His movies Oh God with George Burns and The Jerk starring Steve Martin became instant comedy classics.
When Optograb came out, I thought it was the greatest thing ever, and I bought a pair. And this is the result.
In his later years, Reiner wrote several books, but he never strayed far from his acting roots. Whether it was on TV sitcoms like Mad About You.
We haven't met anywhere before.
No, I'm sure I'd remember.
Oh, yes, yes, you would.
Or on film in the Ocean's 11 franchise.
You're all aces in my book, but I want the last check I write to bounce.
In his personal life, Reiner was married more than 60 years to jazz singer Estelle Reiner, who appeared in their son Rob's film, When Harry Met Sally.
I'll have what she's having.
The Reiners had three children. Their eldest, Rob, became a successful actor turned director. Just like his dad.
He is my idol and the person who has given me not only life, but a direction in life.
Do you pinch yourself a lot?
All the time.
Look at all this.
All the time. How did this happen? It's still a dream.